Good morning, student. This is Divya ma'am, and we are going to do today four small topics of GK. In this topic, there is nothing much to explain. So most of this, we are going to just read straightforward, and I'll explain small words which are here and there. And what you have to do is you have to search about these in Google. Or you can use your prior knowledge if you have, and then answer these four worksheets. Okay, they are very easy. Nothing much is there. So answer these four worksheets and then match your answers with the answer key that would be given. Okay, and you have to do this in your books. Fine. So let's start. The first topic is of page number 22, knowing reptiles. Now tell me, what are reptiles? You have read about reptiles, right? So reptiles are a class of vertebrates. They include snake and lizards, python, crocodile. Okay, and they are mostly cold-blooded animals, and most of them give eggs. Okay, only a few of them give babies, rest of them give eggs. So let's read this fact, and your question says, if the fact is true, then put a tick mark, and if it is false, then put a cross. Okay. Reptiles are different from other vertebrates because they have dry scales covering their bodies. Reptiles different hai because they have dry scales. Scales means layerings covering their body. Now, as you know about them, you might know this fact already. Okay, so let's go ahead. The reticulated python is the longest snake species known. Reticulated python is a type of snake. We have to find out if it is the longest snake species or not. Okay. Reptiles do not have gills. Obviously, they are not fish. So, they do not have gills. They breathe through their lungs. Again, you can cross-check. King cobras are the only snakes in the world that build nest for their eggs. Okay. Turtles are found in Antarctica. Now there are turtles and there are tortoises. So you must find out what is the difference between turtles and tortoises, and then you can find out where turtles are found. Okay. The tortora has a third eye on its head. So, tortora naam ka jo animal hai, it has a third eye on its head. Now, you can again find this out. The largest living lizard is the Komodo dragon. Oh, that's a true fact. Okay. you will be able to see this on Google again, the picture. Saltwater crocodiles, the largest of all crocodiles, are harmless to humans. Salt water mein jo crocodile rehte hain, they are said to be the largest and they are harmless to human. Now you have to tell me if the crocodiles could be harmless to humans. Okay. Now here is tidbits. The tortoises are lizard-like animals. You can see the picture also. Found in a few islands of New Zealand. Kidhar milte hain ye? They are in New Zealand. They live in underground burrows. Underground burrows during the day and come out to feed at night. They are one of the few kinds of reptiles that can endure cold temperatures. Okay, so this is one of the few reptiles who can endure cold temperature. Okay, now in this exercise you have some pictures and you have to give their names. Okay. So most of these you can identify. First one is a snake. Okay. Third one is a green colored lizard type thing. Second one is again a lizard. Now Fourth one is a lizard, but it has some frills around his neck, its neck, and that is a part of adaptation it has done to scare its enemies. Okay, so that it can look bigger than what it is actually. Now, fifth is a green colored snake, and a sixth is very famous crocodile family member. Okay, so do these. And you have the hints given here. Okay, let's move on to your next page. The next page is around the world. This one is page number 24. Okay, and now again these questions are from around the world and you have to find the answers. In which country does the westernmost point of Europe lie? So you have to find out Europe ka westmost point kahan par hai, kis country mein. Which is the largest island in the world? Again, you know this answer. Okay, largest island is the smallest continent also. Which river is the second longest river in Europe? And flows through the capital cities of Vienna, Bratislava, Budapest and Belgrade. Again, you can search for longest river in Europe. Second longest river in Europe. Okay. Which is the most populous landlocked country in the world? Now, what is the meaning of landlocked? Landlocked means a country which is surrounded by other countries all through its border, right? It does not have any seaside. From all the sides, it is surrounded by other lands or countries. Okay, so you have to find out most populous landlocked country in the world. In which island is the pink land iguana found? Now, pink land iguana is a type of animal. So again, you can search with its name and you will be able to find the answer where it is found. Which country has the highest number of lakes in the world? Kaun si country ke paas highest number of lakes? Again, you can search. In which continent is the driest place on the earth located? This must be some desert. So you can again find for this one. Which country along with Russia borders the most number of countries? Aisi kaun si country hai jo रशिया के साथ साथ ऐसी कंट्री है विच बॉर्डर्स द मोस्ट नंबर ऑफ कंट्रीज सबसे ज़्यादा कंट्रीज है उनकी बॉर्डर जो है वो टच होती है दे हैव मोस्ट नंबर ऑफ नेबरिंग कंट्रीज ओके इन विच कंट्री आर नियरली 850 लैंग्वेजेस स्पोकन द मोस्ट इन द वर्ल्ड ऐसी कौन सी कंट्री है जहाँ पे 850 लैंग्वेजेस बोली जाते हैं एंड दैट इज द मोस्ट इन द वर्ल्ड Lesotho is one of the three countries to be completely surrounded by another country. Okay, so that is one country which is completely surrounded by another country. Name the country that surrounds Lesotho. Again, you can search which country surrounds Lesotho. Okay, so look at this. Imagine there is one country and around it there is another country. Okay. In which country is the largest pyramid in the world located? Now, everyone from your class must know this answer. So, where is the largest pyramid in the world? Saigon, a major city in Vietnam, was renamed to honor a famous communist leader. What is its new name? So, you can search for new name of Saigon. Okay, then let's go through the tidbits. The Galapagos Island are located on equator. Where are Galapagos Island located? Equator. When Charles Darwin visited the Galapagos in 1835, he found that the most of the birds, fish, reptiles and plants were different from the species found in other parts of the world. Who was Charles Darwin? He was the father of many theories in our biology. Okay, one of the theory is theory of adaptation, and he has also explained how we became human being. Okay. So what he found out in 1835 that वहाँ पे उस particular island पे the birds, fish, reptiles which are found, they are very different from what are found in the world. These strange animals inspired him to formulate the theory of evolution. ठीक है, तो that is what I was saying, how we became human. So that is called theory of evolution. In his book One of the Origin of Species, तो उन्होंने एक बुक लिखी है On the Origin of Species. Today the islands are a wildlife sanctuary and a national park. Now the Galapagos Island are a wildlife sanctuary as well as a national park. Okay, let's move on to the next page, that is page number 26 in your book. National parks. Okay, we all know national parks, they are part of land that is owned by the government to protect the natural environment and wildlife. Okay, they try to establish a natural habitat for the animals there. Let's read about some famous Indian national parks. Okay, so the top one is Jim Corbett National Park. It is located in Uttarakhand. It was established as Haile National Park in 1936 and later it was renamed to Jim Corbett National Park. The name was later changed in memory of Jim Corbett, a British Indian naturalist. It is India's oldest national park and it is here that the Project Tiger was launched in 1973. So if somebody asks you where was Project Tiger launched, so it was launched in Jim Corbett National Park in 1973. Okay, where is it in? Located Uttarakhand. Now the next one is Keolo Deo Ghana National Park. Keolo Deo Ghana National Park, also called Bharatpur National Park, Bharatpur Bird Sanctuary you might have heard, was formerly a hunting area for the kings of Bharatpur, Rajasthan. वहाँ पे mostly the kings used to come and hunt animals. Okay, it was declared a national park in 1981. When was it declared national park? 1981. Several birds, including the rare Siberian crane, migrate to this area for the winter, earning this park the name of bird paradise. So जब बर्ड माइग्रेट होती हैं, व्हेन डू बर्ड्स माइग्रेट, दे माइग्रेट इन विंटर बिकॉज द बर्ड्स विच लिव इन पोलर रीजन्स, दे कैन नॉट सर्वाइव द विंटर देयर, इट्स वेरी हार्श. सो व्हाट दे डू, दे फ्लो ऑल द वे टू ट्रॉपिकल एंड सब ट्रॉपिकल कंट्रीज. सो सम ऑफ द साइबेरियन क्रेन, दे माइग्रेट टू दिस पर्टिकुलर एरिया फॉर द विंटर. And that's why the park is now called Bird Paradise. And in fact, you won't hear Bharatpur National Park. Mostly you will hear Bharatpur Bird Sanctuary. Okay. Kanjiranga National Park. The Kanjiranga National Park is located in Assam. It is famous for its effort to conserve the one-horned Indian rhinoceros. उसके ओनली वन हॉर्न होती है. ठीक है, इट इज होम टू अ नंबर ऑफ थ्रेटन्ड स्पीशीज एंड माइग्रेटरी बर्ड्स. यहाँ पे बहुत सारी ऐसी स्पीशीज है जो थ्रेटन्ड है, मीन्स दे आर अबाउट टू एंड, दे माइट गो एक्सटिंक्ट. ओके, एंड देर आर माइग्रेटरी बर्ड्स ऑल्सो लाइक साइबेरियन क्रेन, देर माइट बी सम अदर बर्ड. फर्स्ट एस्टैब्लिश्ड इन 1908 as a reserve forest, it became a national park in 1974. So it was established in 1908, but it became a national park in 1974. Now next one is Bandipur National Park. It is situated in Nilgiri Hills in the state of Karnataka, along with Mudumalai Wildlife Sanctuary in Tamil Nadu. Vayanad Wildlife Sanctuary in Kerala and Nagarhole National Park in Karnataka, Bandipur National Karnataka. Okay, so it has three more sanctuaries near it. One is Munnadumalai Wildlife Sanctuary, that is in Tamil Nadu, then Vayanad Wildlife Sanctuary, that is in Kerala, and then one more is Nagarhole National Park, that is also in Karnataka. Okay, Bandipur National Park creates India's biggest biosphere reserve, Nanilgiri Biosphere Reserve. इंडिया का ये सबसे बड़ा बायोस्फीयर रिजर्व है, यहाँ पे सबसे ज़्यादा फॉरेस्टेशन है, ठीक है, एंड इट इज़ कॉल्ड नीलगिरी बायोस्फीयर रिजर्व. ओके, नाउ लेट मी सी एट द क्विक क्विज. सो इट हैज़ गिवन यू नेम ऑफ थ्री नेशनल पार्क एंड यू हैव टू फाइंड आउट द कंट्री वेयर दे आर. ओके, नाउ लेट्स मूव आउट टू द लास्ट टॉपिक ऑफ द डे, दैट इज पेज नंबर 27, मेकिंग लाइफ ईजियर. Okay, making life easier. How do we make our life easier? By inventing things, right? Initially, they used to cook on chula. Now they have gas stove because they are going on, they are inventing things. So here are some inventions which are discussed in this chapter which have made our life easier. There are many inventions that have made our lives easier. Fill in the blanks by using the clues given below. 3M company's chemist Spencer Silver. Which company? 3M, which is very famous for its adhesive. Along with Arthur Fry, accidentally developed. Jo wahan pe dikh rahe hai na, yellow yellow. Yes, very good. In the 1970s. Unhone ye 1970s mein banaye the, but in they were developed by accident. They were not intending to make these things. Okay. What they were intending to do is they were trying to develop a strong adhesive. Bahut strong hai wo adhesive create karne ki koshish kar rahe the, but they found a use for a weak glue instead. Unhe pata chala ki hum weak glue ko kaise use kar sakte hain. Right. Next, move on to second one. British chemist Alexander Parkes made Parkinsine, an early form of. So, आपको पता कर रहा है Parkinsine is a form of what? Okay. The dash was invented by Douglas Engelbart, an American computer professional, and shown to the public in 1968 with the idea of using a computer more efficiently. Now, by the picture only, you can say what it is. Right? Oh, very good. Martin Cooper, an American engineer, made the first dash in 1973 with the help of his team at Motorola. So this one, if you see the picture, you might know the answer. This one was developed by Martin Cooper, who was an American engineer, okay, in 1973. द फर्स्ट सच डिवाइस वेटेड 2 किलोग्राम. तो जो पहली बार ऐसी डिवाइस उन्होंने बनाई थी उसका वेट क्या था? 2 किलोग्राम. नाउ यू नो इट्स ऑलमोस्ट लाइक वेटलेस. ओके, नाउ द नेक्स्ट वन इज सीजर लॉम्ब्रोसो, द फादर ऑफ मॉडर्न क्रिमिनोलॉजी, डिड्यूस्ड दैट द स्ट्रेस ऑफ टेलिंग लाइज वुड कॉज चेंज इन ब्लड फ्लो. This led to the invention of the dash. So, जो सीज़र लॉम्ब्रोसो हैं, वो ही इज़ नोन एज फादर ऑफ मॉडर्न क्रिमिनोलॉजी. ही यूज टू सॉल्व क्रिमिनल केसेस और वर्क ऑन द क्रिमिनोलॉजी. ओके, मीन्स स्टडी ऑफ हैंडलिंग क्रिमिनल्स टाइप ऑफ थिंग. ओके, ही फाउंड आउट दैट व्हेन यू आर टेलिंग लाइज यू फील स्ट्रेस्ड. And if you are feeling stressed, there would be a change in your blood flow. And if your blood flow changes, there would be rise in your BP, right? This led to the invention of the dash. तो इस ये जब उनको पता चला तो उन्होंने क्या invent किया? अगर आप झूठ बोल रहे हो तो आपका BP बढ़ रहा है, तो उसकी बेस पे उन्होंने व्हाट डिड ही इन्वेंट. ओके, नाउ द नेक्स्ट वन इज द डैश वॉज इन्वेंटेड बाय पर्सी स्पेंसर एन अमेरिकन फिजिसिस्ट आफ्टर ही नोटिस दैट माइक्रोवेव्स एक्सीडेंटली मेल्टेड अ कैंडी बार इन हिज पॉकेट. ओके, सो वॉट हैपन्ड दैट पर्सी स्पेंसर ही वॉज डूइंग सम प्रैक्टिकल्स विद माइक्रोवेव्स एंड ही नोटिस दैट इट एक्सीडेंटली मेल्टेड अ कैंडी बार इन हिज पॉकेट. ही हैज़ अ कैंडी बार इन हिज पॉकेट बट इट मेल्टेड बिकॉज ऑफ द माइक्रोवेव्स. ओके, सो दैट्स हाउ ही डेवलप्ड दिस पर्टिकुलर मशीन. Okay, let's see the tidbits. Potato crisps are believed to have been first made by George Crumb. सबसे पहले किसने बताए थे potato crisps या potato chips? George Crumb, a chef at a New York restaurant. Okay, an angry customer at his restaurant sent back the potato fries made by Crumb multiple times. There was a customer in his restaurant. He was very angry. So what he did, he kept on sending back the fries that these are not done properly. Frustrated, Crumb sliced the potatoes really thin and fried them. So उन्होंने क्या किया? नहीं, बस एक तो thin pieces कर दिए, thin slices कर दिए, and then he fried them. Surprisingly, the new variety not only made his customer happy, but also led to the invention of one of the most famous snack foods in the world. ठीक है, तो वो उन्होंने एक्सीडेंटली किया था, बट वो जो कस्टमर था ही वॉज वेरी हैप्पी अबाउट इट. एंड दिस इज ऑल्सो एन इन्वेंशन विच कॉजेज विच लाइक इट्स द मोस्ट फेमस स्नैक इन द वर्ल्ड द पोटैटो चिप्स. ओके, सो हियर वी गो, वी हैव कंप्लीटेड ऑल फोर टॉपिक्स एंड आई वॉन्ट यू टू सॉल्व देम इन योर बुक एंड मैच द आंसर्स. Okay, all the best. Take care.